refine some of the ideas behind it. What we're trying to do is reinforce the best notions, the best parts of what Kickstarter is. And you see that all the time. A project like Iglia. Iglia has been awesome to follow. They've had amazing updates all the way, talking about each phase of what they're going through. This stuff is fascinating. The Pebble. You know, the Pebble, here's a video that Pebble posted called Oodles of Blue. How can you not be excited about that? But, you know, by being a backer of Pebble, you know what it's like to make something in China and what it is to design and manufacture a watch. You understand that Chinese New Year is a really hard time to get something done. There's all these parts of this that suddenly we're exposed to. And this level of transparency we take for granted. We really take for granted. We just assume that this is how things have always been. But before 2 years ago, it didn't work this way at all. At all. Like the idea that you would have some object in your pocket and you would know who was the designer, how was they did it. You could see each phase of the process, that you had that sense of authorship to it, that you knew that entire story, is a completely new concept that we have taken for granted very, very quickly. And that's such a core part of what Kickstarter is about, is that story of where something comes from. See with the Oculus Rift. Oculus Rift has been amazing, amazing for updates in each phase of this. And they aren't keeping trade secrets in this stuff either. I'm sure there's some things that they are, but you know, they talk about here's the biggest challenge and here's how it is that we thought about it. And they're just being totally open, here's the deal. And it's so refreshing. And as a backer, you know, this is just as much what the project is about for me as it is the headset, whatever it is that I get it. And so that part of it, that part is what we're trying to enforce and encourage with Kickstarter's own store. And the thing that we want backers to think about. You also see it with, there's just other ways to present the whole process of making things. I want to show a quick video. This is from a project called the Cosmonaut, which was the second project launched by the Glyph guys.
Do you ever wonder how crayons were made? I've often thought about people making crayons. I'll do some more of this later, but I'd like to show you some people making crayons. Let's come along. I have a film of it here. Thank you. people take those boxes to the stores where other people come to buy them. So they buy the crayons.
You know, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. The idea that that would be something interesting is amazing. But it really is. Just being able to see that and see where things come from is really special. So, you know, Kickstarter Design Store on the one hand was, you know, setting a different set of expectations and setting some new rules. But also, I think Kickstarter Design Store is an awesome thing because it's kind of better than a store. You know, you have a giant riding walking robot that you can be a part of creating. A really interesting minesweeper that someone's putting to work in Afghanistan. This is not something you find in a store. A open source Geiger counter for people to use in Japan to detect radiation levels after the Fukuyama disaster. The first civilian spacesuit designed by a cosmonaut. A cocktail dispensing robot, this one is currently funding now. You know, Kickstarter is not a store, it's a place where people are coming together to make things. As a backer, you're not a consumer, you are a participant, you're a collaborator, you're helping to create right alongside the creator. And that's the really special thing about it. So, you know, that's the idea I'd really like to leave you with today, so thanks a lot.